45 years after the Whitlam dismissal, the missing chapter in Australia's most volatile political drama is about to be told. The High Court has ruled letters written by the Queen to Sir John Kerr can be made public. Lane Calcutt with more.
They're the most famous or infamous words in the history of Australian politics, maybe the nation's history.
Well, may we say, God save the Queen. God save the Queen! Because nothing will save the Governor-General.
November 11, 1975, Sir John Kerr, the Governor-General, had just sacked the Whitlam government. Gough Whitlam mobbed on the steps of Old Parliament House, supporters up in arms over what would be known as a dismissal. What went on behind closed doors, though, has remained a mystery for 45 years. We've never known what was said between Government House in Canberra and the palace half a world away. But today the High Court decided we have the right to know.
It's a great decision for transparency and for the right to know. It's a story that has been absolutely clouded in secrecy, in distortion.
It's a victory for Whitlam biographer and academic Jenny Hocking, who challenged the National Archives classification that the 211 potentially explosive letters were personal and not official Commonwealth records.
We can no longer have a situation where the Queen or the monarch exercises any control over our national historical documents.
It gives Australians the right to know just how much an unelected lady in England or otherwise had to do with the dismissal of a democratically elected Australian government.
The Queen's former press secretary says the monarch wouldn't be too concerned.
And I would have thought that the right time for the release of these documents is on the demise of the Crown.
Classifying the letters personal meant they were embargoed until 2027 and the Queen had a veto over their release. It's not known when they'll be available to the public. Lane Calcutt, Nine News.